This video is about abelian groups. Our goals for this video are to state the definition of an abelian group, to work a few examples and non-examples, and provide a concept check. This video is designed to be used right after you become familiar with the definition of a group, so it doesn't contain a whole lot of more advanced examples such as symmetric groups and the like. But you should be familiar with the integers mod n and with matrices. And one of the proofs mentions Bézout's lemma, so you should be familiar with that as well. We will use the following notational conventions. The set of positive integers will be denoted by n, the set of all integers by z, the set of rational numbers by q, the set of real numbers by r, the set of all complex numbers by c, and if we put a plus sign in the superscript, that will denote the set of all positive elements of that set. And K star will denote the set of all non-zero elements of K, where K is Q, R, C, or ZP, where P is prime. For an integer n greater than or equal to 2, Zn will denote the additive group of integers modulo n, and GLn of K will be the set of all invertible n by n matrices with entries in K, where K could be Q, R, C, or ZP, where P is prime. Okay, so here is our basic definition. Let G be a group with operations star. We say that G is an abelian group if star is a commutative operation, that is, that A star B equals B star A for all A and B in the group. Most of the groups that you've seen so far are abelian groups. For example, Z under addition, Q under addition, R under addition, C under addition. The set of all non-zero rational numbers under multiplication is also an abelian group. Same thing with R star and C star. Zn is a group under addition. The set of positive rational numbers also forms a group under multiplication, and the same with the set of all positive real numbers under multiplication. We're going to focus on this last one, ZP star, where P is prime, it turns out is an abelian group under multiplication. Okay, so let P be a prime number, then ZP star is an abelian group under multiplication. You can see that I have representatives for all the congruence classes mod P, except for 0. So a sketch of the proof. Multiplication of congruence classes is well defined. And moreover, the product of two non-zero congruence classes will be non-zero. So ZP star is closed under multiplication. Multiplication of congruence classes is associative, since multiplication of integers is associative. The identity element here is the class of 1, which is in ZP star. So now we need to check that ZP star has all its inverses. So let A be an element of ZP star. This is where we use the fact that P is prime. Since P is prime, we know that the GCD of A and P is 1. By Bézout's lemma, there is a linear combination of A and P that equals 1. So we can express 1 as AX plus PY for some integers X and Y. Thus, the class of 1 is the class of AX plus PY, which is the class of AX plus the class of 0. And that's the class of A times the class of X. So notice now that we have the class of A times the class of X equals the class of 1. So that means that the class of A has an inverse element, the class of X. And finally, we can note that ZP star is abelian because multiplication of congruence classes commutes. So now let's talk about some non-examples. GL2 of R, that's the group of 2x2 invertible matrices with real entries. You can check that this is a group under matrix multiplication. And this group is non-abelian, since, for example, you can multiply these two matrices together, 2, 0, 1, 1, and 0, 1, negative 1, 0. If you multiply them in that order, you get the matrix 0, 2, negative 1, 1. But if you switch the order, you get a different matrix, 1, 1, negative 2, 1. And therefore, these matrices do not commute. An important remark here, note that for a group G to be abelian, we must have A times B equals B times A for all A and B in the group. So to show that G is not abelian, we need only show that there exist elements A and B that do not commute with one another. Indeed, it is not possible to have a group G in which none of the elements commute, since, in particular, every element commutes with itself. In other words, AA, that's A squared, that's AA, so certainly A commutes with itself. Every element commutes with the identity element for the group, since AE equals EA, that's just A, for all A in G, and every element commutes with its inverse. Okay, so A has an inverse element, and A times A inverse is the same as A inverse A, they're both equal to E. Okay, so we come to our next non-example. I've written non-example one, but it's really kind of our second one. Let's consider GL2 of Z2. This is the set of invertible 2x2 matrices with entries in Z2. As a concept check, show that GL2 of Z2 is a non-abelian group under matrix multiplication with 6 elements. Here you should pause the video and try to work out as much of this as you can on your own before going on. Okay, so the entries of matrices in GL2 Z2 are ones and zeros, and I'm just going to go ahead and suppress the brackets there because I don't want, in other words, instead of writing bracket, 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 I'm just going to write instead 1, 0, 0, 1, okay? But we're to understand these entries as being elements of Z2, and when we multiply the matrices, we will do the multiplication in Z2. The entries of these matrices are ones and zeros, and in order to be invertible, we need to have at least 2 ones. We can't have 3 zeros in the entries, or we'll have a row or column with zeros, and then that matrix will not be invertible. And so of course we can't have all ones because then the determinant would be zero and that would not be invertible. So after trial and error, you should get these 6 matrices. We have the identity matrix, of course, 1, 0, 0, 1. And this matrix that I've called A, and we'll see why in a moment, but 1, 1, 1, 0. And this matrix B, 0, 1, 1, 0. And then in order to be closed under multiplication, A squared has to be in our group. And if you take A squared, which is A times A, you'll get 0, 1, 1, 1. You can check that A cubed, which is A squared times A, that's 0, 1, 1, 1, times A, which is 1, 1, 1, 0, when you multiply these matrices together, you get 1, 0, 0, 1, and that's the identity matrix. So, in fact, multiplying A by itself more than twice is not going to get you anything new. If you take A times B, you're going to get 1, 1, 0, 1. And if you take A squared times B, you're going to get 1, 0, 1, 1. And these are all the invertible matrices. So as we've already mentioned, A cubed is the identity matrix. And B squared is also the identity matrix. So we won't get any new matrices by multiplying B by itself more than once. And you can also check that B times A is equal to A squared B. So in particular, BA is not equal to AB. So we'll come back to that. So if we look at a Cayley table for GL2Z2 with the names A and B and so on that I've created here, you can note some interesting features that will help us prove that this is really a group. First of all, matrix multiplication is associative, so that's taken care of. And from the Cayley table, we can also see that this set is closed under matrix multiplication. I'm here multiplying in the order of this first column by the first row. So in particular, for example, A times B is here as AB in this entry. And every time I multiply one of these elements by one of the other elements, I'm going to get one of the elements in the group. So we do have closure here. The identity element is I, the identity matrix. And as far as inverses, A and A squared are inverses of each other because we saw that if we multiply A by A squared, we get the identity matrix. We worked that out before. And of course, that's the same thing as A times A squared. And you can check that all the other elements are their own inverses. For example, B times B is I. We worked that out. AB times AB is I. A squared B times A squared B is I. And of course, I times I is I. So GL2Z2 is a group. And as we hinted at before, in particular, A times B is not equal to B times A. A times B is AB. And B times A, we can just do this here real quick. Here's B, and here's A. So that's 1, 0, 1, 1. And that is the matrix that I labeled with A squared B. And of course, you can double check that, A squared B is 0, 1, 1, 1 times 0, 1, 1, 0. This is A squared, and this is B. And sure enough, we get 1, 0, 1, 1. Whereas if we take A times B, we get 1, 1, 0, 1. So certainly not equal to BA. Here's another non-example. And maybe my count is off here. But let G be the set of all bijective functions from R to R. The claim is that G is a non-abelian group under composition of functions. So as a sketch of this proof, certainly by properties of functions, if F and G are bijective functions from R to R, then G of F is bijective. So G is closed under composition. Composition of functions is associative. For an identity element, let I be the identity function. Then you can check that I of F equals F of I. And that's the same as the function F for all F belonging to G. And finally, for inverses, let F be an arbitrary element of G. Since F is bijective, F has an inverse function. That is also bijective. Thus, F inverse belongs to G. Thus, G is a group under composition of functions. So it remains to show that G is non-abelian. As a challenge, you could pause the video right now and try to come up with an example yourself of two bijective functions, F and G, from R to R, such that F of G is not equal to G of F. So feel free to pause the video and work that up for yourself. Here's the example that I came up with. Consider F defined by F of X equals 2X, and G defined by G of X equals X plus 1, for all real numbers X. You can check that F and G are bijective, so they belong to the group G. Then, G of F of X is equal to 2X plus 1, but F of G of X is equal to 2 times X plus 1, which is 2X plus 2. So you can double check that these are different functions because they have different assignments. G of F of 1 is equal to 3, whereas F of G of 1 is equal to 4. Therefore, G of F is not equal to F of G. So the group G is non-abelian. Okay, so to summarize, an abelian group is a group G such that AB equals BA for all A and B belonging to G. A group G is non-abelian if there exist elements A and B that do not commute with one another. As a question for further thought, can you show that GLN of R is non-abelian for all n greater than or equal to 2? I hope you found this video helpful.